Hello friends, let us now learn about the distal or type 1 renal tubular acidosis. So, for this renal tubular acidosis, in the collecting duct, we have alpha intercalated cells. Okay, in the collecting duct, in the alpha intercalated cells, in the apical surface, this is alpha intercalated cells, this is lumen, this is blood. So, this is the apical surface, this is the basolateral surface. Now, on the apical surface of alpha intercalated cell of cortical collecting duct, we have H plus ATPase pump. So, whenever there is this H plus ATPase pump will help in secretion of H plus ions. Whenever there is some defect in the mutation in the H plus ATPase pump, this will prevent the excretion of or secretion of H plus ions in the lumen, resulting in metabolic acidosis. This is an autosomal recessive condition which is associated with sensory neural hearing loss. Then it can also occur due to one more mutation. This distal renal tubular acidosis also occurs due to second mutation which is seen in the basolateral membrane. Now, in the basolateral membrane, we have an exchanger called as chloride bicarbonate exchanger. This chloride bicarbonate exchanger will help in secretion of chloride and reabsorption of bicarbonate. This will help in secretion of chloride and reabsorption of bicarbonate. Whenever there is mutation in this receptor, there is no reabsorption of bicarbonate. Right? Whenever there is no reabsorption of bicarbonate, that is bicarbonate is excreted. Because of this, bicarbonate is excreted. Obviously, excretion of bicarbonate also results in metabolic acidosis. Right? This is the second type of mutation. Third mutation affecting in renal tubular acidosis is the mutation in carbonic anhydrase gene. Normally, this carbonic anhydrase 2 enzyme present in the collecting duct will combine carbon dioxide plus H2O to H2CO3, that is carbonic acid, which will cause excretion of H plus through the same H plus ATPase pump. With the help of H plus ATPase pump, this H plus is excreted, and with the help of this chloride bicarbonate exchanger, this bicarbonate is excreted, right? With same pump, I drew it again, but still. Okay, with the same pump, the H plus is excreted and bicarbonate is excreted through chloride bicarbonate transporter. Now, whenever there is defect in this mutation in this carbonic anhydrase enzyme, because of this mutation in carbonic anhydrase enzyme, the carbon dioxide and H2O cannot form carbonic acid, and this carbonic acid cannot be dissociated into H plus and HCO3. So there is no reabsorption of H plus ion, and there is no secretion of H plus ion, and there is no reabsorption of bicarbonate. So this will also result in distal renal tubular acidosis or type 1 renal tubular acidosis. Right? Fine. Now, this disease is, so if you see the clinical features here, the patients present with metabolic acidosis, they will also present with these conditions. They will present with hypokalemia, hypocitraturia, they will present with hypercalciuria, that is increased calcium excretion in the urine, which will result in stone formation. That is, they will also present with nephrolithiasis. So they will present with hypokalemia, hypocitraturia, hypercalciuria, and they will present with stone formation, that is nephrolithiasis and nephrocalcinosis. And this is most common, if this is an autosomal recessive condition, most commonly seen in infants. In the infants, it presents with obviously acidosis and also impaired growth, and failure to thrive is seen in infants. And there are some forms of autosomal dominant conditions and also some autosomal recessive conditions which are asymptomatic. Most of the autosomal dominant conditions are asymptomatic. Most of the autosomal recessive conditions are symptomatic. But there are some autosomal recessive conditions which can be asymptomatic. So, treatment, if you see, treatment is you will have to replace the alkali. So, for here, the bicarbonate is lost in the blood. So, you will have to preserve the bicarbonate. So, for preserving bicarbonate, we can give HCO3 minus, that is bicarbonate supplementation, 1 to 3 millimoles per kg per day is given. This will correct the acidosis. Right? Then, because it will correct the acidosis and it will also correct the hypokalemia, thus it is helpful. If there is stone presentation, then obviously you should increase the fluid intake. And in this distal tubular renal tubular acidosis, the main problem is in the acid imbalance. So once you correct the imbalance in acidosis, then automatically all the others will get corrected. So this is about distal renal tubular acidosis. Thank you for watching my lecture. Thank you.